Hello there, my name is Dart Chart, and you're watching the Top 5 Plays of the Week brought to you by Chaos Cinema. And as the trend continues, here is the Top 5 Snipers of the Call of Duty franchise. Remember to send in your clips to the Top 5 series through the links below in order to be featured in next week's episode. At number 5, we have the Black Ops L96, and snipers were fairly rare in Black Ops considering how weak they actually were, but when it comes down to it, this was the sniper rifle of choice, considering its predictability and ability to get one-shot kills at any given range, as long as it was from the waist up, including the neck, chest, and upper arms. This weapon was actually pretty good, you just had to take some getting used to. And it looks really good gold. But, cosmetic appearances aside, not the strongest sniper rifle on this list, so let's go ahead and move on forward to number 4. At number 4, we have the Modern Warfare 2 iteration of the Barrett 50 cal, a weapon that has been in nearly all of the Call of Duty so far, and is known for its high damage and high spam ability. Quick but steady aim makes it a very deadly weapon in close range, even for a sniper rifle, just because of that ability to hammer down on the fire button and get those close range kills. With or without stopping power, this weapon is very dependable and gets a lot of one-shot kills, but Modern Warfare 3 seems to be overshadowed by the weapon at number 3, which comes in at the MSR. You could also make a case here that the L118 would take the spot, but they're basically the same weapon, excepting for cosmetic appearances. I have to say, though, when it comes down to feeling, the MSR takes the cake and is probably the reason why I play Modern Warfare 3 at all. This weapon just feels so great, looks great gold, and picks up those one-shot kills even when you don't expect them to, it seems like. I don't know, it's one of those magic weapons, I guess. But if anything must be said, the MSR was not at the top of this list because of classic nostalgia, and I'm sure some of you will disagree with that and want to argue because you think nostalgia is an old, old wooden ship during the Civil War era. But it seems some of us still have an appreciation for those sort of things, i.e. me, and if you don't like it, well then you can fight me in PAX next year. But until then, let's push forward with number 2, where we're going to find the Modern Warfare 2 Intervention, the tool of the trick shotters everywhere. The only thing you'll see in Modern Warfare 2 S&D, and namely, the most important sniper rifle of this game. Very, very consistent, easy to get those one-shot kills from just about anywhere above the waist, and is very, very popular with the trick-shotting community because of its feel, its sound, and overall usability, so it would seem. The 50 cal is, in fact, a better weapon statistically, but that doesn't stop people from using the intervention pretty much all the time. I have to say, though, I do enjoy using this weapon myself. But there is always one sniper that is held above the rest, and that is the Big Boss Mac Daddy M40A3 sniper rifle from Call of Duty 4. The OG bolt action that everyone consequently learned to snipe on. You remember this as the legend that started it all. When Call of Duty became mainstream, this was the source of the average man's trick-shotting montage because of its dependability and accuracy and ability to take out enemies from just about any range at any given time. You also see it as the original source of the ACOG. The M40 ACOG was unique because of its aim-down sight ability coupled with a very instantaneous amount of increased damage, simply to the M40, which allowed it to eliminate hit markers, making no scopes and such that much easier, as you could take out one-shot kills from the left leg, left testicle, left side of the face, and it's all still just one shot, making it one of the best sniper rifles of all time, and easily my favorite. That's it, guys. Remember to send me your top 5 plays and links below, and check out the channels involved in making this awesome series that you guys watch every week here on Chaos Silencer's channel. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. My name is Dart Chart. I will see you guys.